Vanuatu with the three Pacific Island countries such as Fiji, Samoa and Niue account for about 70% of the land area of the Polynesia-Micronesia biodiversity hotspot, where species endemism is particularly high, and one-third to one-half of species are currently threatened with extinction. With the population growth and the pressure that people put on land in terms of the use of natural resources for food and other basic needs, and also other issues that are affecting the world today, Vanuatu is no exception and is also facing the same challenges as other countries of managing the use of its natural resources and the development and the welfare of its people. Nowadays, the activities of man have contributed a lot in the destruction of the biodiversity of our islands, thus putting in danger our fragile ecosystem. As part of its effort to protect its resources and maintain sustainable growth and development, the Government of the Republic of Vanuatu, through the Department of Forestry and Environment, is working in collaboration with various international agencies that provide financial and technical assistance to sustainably manage its forests. In this year 2013, GEFPAS, or Global Environment Facility, and Pacific Alliance for Sustainability are funding a project on forestry and protected area management, which aims to conserve Vanuatu's biodiversity. The Food and Agriculture of the United Nations FAO comes in as an implementing agency, providing technical aspects to the project. The project also focuses on educating the people about the importance of protecting natural resources and managing protected areas, as this is enshrined in the Constitution of the Republic of Vanuatu, which states that every person has the fundamental duty to protect the Republic of Vanuatu and to safeguard the natural wealth, resources and environment in the interest of the present generation and of future generations.
The Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, with financial support of the Global Environment Facility, implements a conservation project, forestry and protected area management in the four countries, which are Fiji, Samoa, Vanuatu and Niue in the South Pacific.
It's a four-year project, and Vanuatu was fortunate to be chosen among other countries for three reasons.
Project I consider lo Vanuatu from I consistent with them Vanuatu's priorities for biodiversity conservation, where I national biodiversity strategic action plan we got in place with this. So that's why all donors always have a consider on Vanuatu no more through National Biodiversity Strategic Action Plan we UMICAT, and that's why Luan and Lo Project can come into Lo Vanuatu. And two, and we consider as well from Vanuatu, we also one biodiversity hotspot where full of species, all plants, all animals, only in danger of extinction finish due to the pressure of populations. And two, Lo national level, we Vanuatu say, we got all weaknesses, Lo site, Lo institutional. Framework law, site legislations and policy.
The project will focus on four sites that have been identified on four different islands of Vanuatu: the Kauri Reserve on Eromango, Bay Homo in South Pentecost, Penoru in West Coast Santo, and Lake Letes on Gaua Island.
Project is one important project where we link him forestry. I go with them one conservation activity where Mr. Wandem make them. Project there, hemi no also mol narola project where one by forestry no more hemi run them, and then another one by environment department by hemi run them. But project there, tuvela department one time, tuvela run them. Jointly run them project there. So all issues, lo side lo bush, yumi lo forestry, yumi look plantel hem. And all issues where hemi concern them activity we manage conserve them or protect them, you mean lo environment, you mean look lo hem.
The project has five different components, which the project coordinator aims to achieve during the four-year period. 1. To improve legislation and policy. 2. To extend and consolidate the protected area network. 3. To strengthen the capacity for community-based conservation management. 4. To put in place mechanisms for sustainable protected area financing. And 5. To ensure a sustainable use of biodiversity.
Lo bien lo department molsem focal point lo CEF lo Vanuatu miklat bi one we yumisave development project ya lo four main pilot sites na be mi sabe se on lessons plan ba yumisave serem throughout Vanuatu mo no Vanuatu no ba yumisave serem to lo region mo even globally.
In terms of policy and legislation, the government has put in place the Forestry Act, which deals with the management of natural forests and the protection of the biodiversity, the Forest Policy, which provides direction and guidelines to utilize and manage our resources, and the Environmental Management and Conservation Act, which focuses on the protection of the environment.
Overall, we're looking at all legislation, all the stuff in place, where we bring me some guidelines. How now you must have manage them, how now you must have utilize them, all resources play me, so that all benefits play them, all next generation play me will come behind, will start to utilize them.
In March this year, a team led by Rudolf Hahn and Presley Dovo from the FAO office made a first visit to one of the four sites on Gaua Island to talk to people and communities as part of the awareness program on conservation management and sustainable use of forest biodiversity. Gaua Island is situated in the far north of the archipelago of the Republic of Vanuatu and is part of a group of islands which form the Banks Group. Gaua was chosen because it possesses the largest lake in Vanuatu that holds many different species.
Purpose blo three blo kadan lo Gaua hemi mainly blo provide them informations or disseminate them informations awareness make lo public blo communities around lo Gaua blo only understand them why na project make lo Gaua mo to abe blo look lo site where we been identified some like latest me one site to me been identified blo project here. And finally, producing one documentary where we have a whole bunch of people, communities, national level too, always have understanding importance of biodiversity or resources for humans that can.
Upon our arrival on the island, the team met with the local chiefs and community leaders for a final briefing on the preparations and arrangements of the meetings that will be held during the week. Freshly, a local businessman who owns one of the only three trucks on the whole island, drove us to Siriti village on the eastern coast, where we were going to stay. It took us about an hour to travel on rugged roads to finally come to the village.
It's quite a remote island here. No roads, I was told. Only some tracks to get around. But it looks quite challenging and a bit adventurous as well.
Formerly known as Santa Maria Island, Gaua is the largest of the Banks Islands in Toba Province, and it covers an area of 342 square kilometers. It has a population of about 2,500 people, which are scattered in coastal villages around the island. The population of Gaua lives on the agricultural economy of Melanesia, combining fishing and horticulture, and the main exports are copra and cocoa. It has rugged terrain, reaching up to Mount Gharat, which is 767 meters above sea level, and it's the peak of the active stratovolcano at the center of the island. Mm-hmm. The community of Siriti village hosted the first meeting, where people from the nearby villages came together to meet the team. While a group of villagers were busy preparing the food for all the participants, the consultation meeting began with presentations on different aspects of the project and protected area management. One of the aims of the project is to empower the community to take ownership of the project and a leading role in conservation activities.
Project where we come in, we got the three objectives where you must have a work with them. Firstly, we want to conserve my biodiversity in Vanuatu. We through consolidating more, we want to expand them all networks, low side low protected areas, so that you must have got one good for linkages, you must have got good for connections. But more lot of protected areas, more to conserve them all biodiversity, blame me where we start, all resources, blame me. And two, you want them to build up one capacity side of conservation management, and two, sustainable use of biodiversity. I mean, very important, especially community level, national level, you may build up capacity for people, so that people also come understand them all resources here, and two, look at all skills, also enhance them, or rather, manage them all resources to start level of community. And finally, you may reduce some all forest and land degradation.
The participants shared their views on the degradation of their forest and admitted that today, people tend to go up further on the mountains to cut trees and other bush materials for building purposes, thus putting pressure on resources. They all agreed that it is vitally important to preserve them for the future generations.
Conserve all area plumi from lo sample lo sample place plumi mi look se lo environment some vala some lo reef plumi ya all mano di nokia
said lo workshop ya I help me blo mo by mi sai lo kotem kotol life lo some the way stuff inside lo environment with me patlehem. Emi help me too lo all places lo mi susi mi come back. Ba mi kat responsibility mi sai mi kem lo every day, especially for protecting environment we stop surrounding me.
Allo set lo mi ol se one mama mi look se emi important to mas pus we you mi sabe you mi follow all advice we stop give him lo. You may live with him, blow make him sim by lo time by he come by all picnic play you mean bamba or in a subisot lo one something.
First time some lo living blue blow today, you missed up thinking no more say by you missed up make a more work with blow some especially or some small mole boost or all environment dreamy low island we be naya I'm even come looks over me been cut save small lo. Lo lu sai no mo se hi mi sa spole implante o la resource primi o hi mi no sa timbot se o le picha se nerisen we bali gambien bali o geta tu bali benefit lo wane we hi mi sa benefit lem tete
kaman emi lu sa be se emi important no emi kat one time lo make sure se lo wo ko te mol communities lo o li sa be aware lo importance lo make em conservation. Most same time, me help lo give hand lo get atu lo. How now only save come back lo. Make them cut planning. Most same time only save committee mol get lo make sure she only stop using all resources. Be only you must apply some fashion lo make them see all resources. I stop all time.
The second meeting took place in Lemoga village, one of the largest villages in the northeast of Gaua. We started our journey by traveling with a boat due to bad road conditions, and it took us about 30 minutes travel along the coast until we reached the seashores of Lemoga. After a 10-minute walk, we finally came to the village where the chiefs and the people were already waiting for us.
On behalf of the chief, the Lemoga, the people of the Lemoga, I would like to thank you for your support. Or me will start taking time to tell you one warm welcome. You will have Nasara. And me open, you will have, you will have make him one name. Ting ting, where you will come blow, talk about with him.
After a warm welcome by the elders and the villagers, the team was led to the main Nakamal or center, which was the venue of the meeting. It was packed with people coming in from surrounding villages. Presley then highlighted the importance of protecting Lake Letes and preserving its biodiversity, as it is a home not only for eels and many other species that live underwater, but also a habitat for other species of animals and plants that live in the nearby forest. Today, many of those endemic species are in danger of extinction, and the community is aware of the impact that the people are causing to their forest as the population is growing. The project will help the communities to make an assessment of the biodiversity of the lake, to do a mapping of the area, to make a socio-economic survey, and to set up a committee to facilitate the works to be done.
All some people start the lake, got all pitching. Ol namarai, ol naura, mol crab lobus, ol wild duck, ol wild fowl. By we must look them good from naya olista plus pick one.
Me been start to come time when me begini, so me been find them out say every fish we been start lose water. Olo sabi se mista olo emoti plo kota namo. Me been start pick one ega mista shoot lombunara. Olo sabi se mista tun fish lo start lo lek plumi.
Osem yumi ko kilimon animal, yumi tawon animal trees, pe yumi no timbota life limi from se all trees na all stop giving yumi all good vela air we yumi breathe in and out, mo all animal, mo something we start lo solo tal sem fish, yumi sta karem be yumi no sabe se yumi sta kilimon life lo something.
The last meeting was held in the village of Masliliu, which was 2 kilometers away from where we stayed. Again, we had to travel by boat to go there. On our way, we stopped in the village of Aver, where we had the opportunity to see some women performing water music. Water music is unique to the people and the women of Gaua, as they are the custodians of this traditional art. It's a combination of rhythms and movements of hands in the water, which create different sounds, and it is accompanied with tales and songs about nature and daily living. After the performance, we headed to Masliliu village for the final meeting. Daniel, an agriculture field worker of the island, took us to the village, and as soon as we arrived, the program started with the presentation of the project and the benefits that it will generate.
Ul tok tok lo conserve mol resources lo islandia mi klatle mo meeting se lo fi chambai kamba mi sa help mol community lo mi o witem home lo mi o witem islandia ba mi lei look out kut lo resources lo islandia ol se mol resources lo soil water ol resources lo water mo ol resources lo land ol se mol trees mo every resource from everyone important, all same me human way life lo me important more all resources too all important more misave benefit lem with them all generation after lo me
project em important Thomas from se emisave keep him all kata resource all kata something we live in mi belai lusum finish so meeting si project ya pai mi camp lo remind them all people lo make him sure si all something we pin dus finish poli mas kamba
arol mi bela na mi bela masko men lip lo tok tok lo wan wan ausol lo mi bela long wenem we em stop lo conserve area mo tok tok especially every community members we live inside lo community.
The activities of conservation and area management will bring a lot of benefits to the people and communities living in the island. It will empower local communities to lead and participate in conservation activities, assist in mobilization of resources and improve management of resources, develop incentives for biodiversity conservation and forest management in communities, develop capacity building in resource management, increase land productivity, improve local environment and better opportunities for sustainable rural development, and generate income in terms of researches and studies. This will also help the people to develop ecotourism as a means of earning income to sustain their livelihood.
I mean, we believe that through the project, some economic returns equal all landowners, especially lo side lo ecotourism where you meet thinking lo building in through lo project here.
I think the people I try to combat conservation area lo place every member of the future, especially now lo side lo tourism where I'm saying make him income long people lo government, more people lo island, more especially lo community.
The project is of a significant importance to Vanuatu, as not only it will enable us to protect the biodiversity of our islands, but also to mitigate against the impact of climate change.
You must protect them, takbus plu yumi, plu make them sure say climate change, impact plu climate change, you sabe mitigate against them, or all takbus plu yumi, sabe help plu absorb them, all rubbish cast away, all narvla kandre, all saputu miko andab lo air, all lo space, all atmosphere. At the same time tak busi stop hemi holem tight crown. Hemi holem tight crown, I make se rent time I rent big one also one em. Crown inokam lo cos crown we I lose time lo three nokat or tak busi nokat. Ren I rent big one, I was a mouth crown, I go lo river blimi, is polem all fish, all naura lo river. At the same time, some like is polem place plot drink water blimi, or place plot water. So mo same time I run heavy rain, I was same crown, is pole inos pole river no mo, is pole mo reef limi to same time.
Before the team returned to Port Vila, we decided to take a walk to the famous lake and the waterfall, as we cannot live without seeing these beauties of the island. In the morning of the fifth day, as the sun was rising up, we set out for the long journey. We knew that it was not going to be an easy ride. The road is tough, sloppy, and we had to walk up steep mountains to get to the top, so we made sure that we had the right gear to get there. We were grateful to have John and Macklin with us as our guide, so they led us through the village, right through the deep jungle. For the boys, it was just a normal routine, but for us, It was a challenge, as we are not used to walk such a long distance, but it was worth a try. We were astonished by the beauty of the scenery, the landscape, the water, and the deep and green forest. It took us about 3 hours to finally arrive at the summit.
We are right on the caldera.
Chief Victor and two other boys were already waiting for us. They came up from the other side of the island, as all the villages have their own road to the lake.
Happy to see you.
It was a really tough walk. We were a bit exhausted, but as we reached the peak, the scenery was just so magnificent that we quickly forgot our fatigue. It was well worth it. We had a quick lunch, then the men took us for a tour around the lake on a canoe. It was unbelievable. Here we are, paddling in the biggest lake of the entire South Pacific. In the background, the mighty and active volcano, Mount Gharat, offers a real postcard that is rarely seen elsewhere. Lake Letes has a unique landscape on its own, with rocks and forest along the coast, and the hills form a wall around it. There's fresh water everywhere coming from the rocks and hillside and flowing into the lake, and it's a habitat for many living creatures like eels and shrimps, but also birds, ducks, and many more. It's a whole ecosystem in itself. As the sun was about to set on Mount Gharat, the team went ashore and set up the tents for the night. The next day, we packed our bags and left the lake to our next destination. After walking for 1.5 hours on a narrow and slippery road, we finally came to the beautiful Siri waterfall. The panoramic view was just spectacular, and from where we were, about 100 meters away, we could hear the water splashing from 120 meters high. The amount of water that falls is so huge that when it reaches the bottom, it creates a massive sound, like a cyclone that sweeps the surrounding area. The scene was so impressive. We were all stunned by this beautiful and magnificent wonder of Gaua Island, and it's something that some of us have never seen before. The island of Gaua is so rich in biodiversity, and it contains some of the endemic species of flora and fauna that are unique in Vanuatu. It possesses some of the attractive wonders that cannot be found elsewhere. Therefore, the need to protect this biodiversity is so vital.
Lo Vanuatu olitalem se yumika 3,270 animal mol plan. 3,270. Pe outlaw animal ya ika teti nomo we yumika tol study we study lem. It means 2,000 over 2,000. Or even 3,000 were humino statimate.
The trip to Gaua coincides with the coming of another team of scientists led by Dr. Robert Schabetsberger from the University of Salzburg in Austria, who came as well to do some researches on the biodiversity of Lake Letes.
In 2004 and 2005, I had the chance to come through the entire South Pacific on a self-funded project where we studied lakes starting in Tahiti, Cook Islands, Fiji, Samoa, Tonga, Wallis and Futuna, and finally Vanuatu. And from 39 lakes, which I think included most larger lakes, throughout the South Pacific Islands, Lake Letters was something very, very specific. It is the largest lake in remote Oceania. It is 100 meters deep. It is constantly fertilized by the active volcano.
The active volcano, Mount Gharat, plays an active and important role in the stability of this mini ecosystem. There are a lot of hot springs coming into the lake from the volcano, and they are thought to be nutrient-rich.
The important thing for living animals is that there is a lot of oxygen all the way down to the bottom. At 40 meters, we've still found 50% of oxygen, which is a lot, and at the bottom we still found about 4.3% of oxygen. That means that the whole lake is a habitat for living organisms, animals, that they can survive at these conditions. What I also want to do is to focus on all living organisms that exist in the lake. So there are the plants that are on the shore and the algae that are in the water and the zooplankton, so little small creatures living in the water. And also all these small organisms like snails and insects living on the shore and in the bottom.
During their first trip, Dr. Robert was surprised to see the villagers catching massive eels in the lake, and that caught his attention. He found out that in a certain season, those eels usually make their way out of the lake and follow the only outflow down to the ocean. Since then, he decided to focus his studies on eel migration. Therefore, in 2012, he came back with a group of scientists and researchers, and they started to tag the eels.
There's actually three species in the system. There is marbled eels. They have a very wide distribution range that also goes from the Pacific into the Indian Ocean. There is Pacific long-finned eels. It's Anguilla megastoma. It's probably the most enigmatic species. It's the eel of the mountains. They reach the last little creeks up there. So they're known throughout the entire South Pacific. This was the original target species.
The purpose of tagging these eels is to understand their life cycle and also to locate their spawning grounds in order to better manage the species.
So the eels actually have a life cycle, what we call catadromous. They live in freshwater for many years. We don't know yet exactly how long they live in Lake Letters. And eventually they get hormonally ready to migrate to the ocean for spawning. They change, they get silvery, they get larger eyes, they adapt for swimming in the ocean. And then eventually they just go out and they migrate several hundred kilometers, if not thousands of kilometers. We don't yet know because the spawning grounds are still unknown. We have strong indication for Anguilla marmorata, where this one specimen migrated some 850 kilometers towards Tuvalu, that the spawning grounds are located somewhere there. We're putting these tags on to follow them all the way to their spawning grounds. And then they spawn there. It's only known so far from Japanese eels, you know, that they spawn during new moon periods in about 200 meters depth, often using what we call a front. This is where different water masses of different temperature, different salinity are meeting. And then these small larvae, they drift back, in this case with the so-called south equatorial current. And they make slowly their way back, they grow, they eventually develop what we call glass eels. They are very transparent little creatures and they can smell the fresh water. And then they make their way up, then they get pigmented, they become what we call elvers. And these elvers are obviously able to surmount the sides of cirifalls. Of course, not the waterfall itself, but they must be able to crawl up on the flanks, on the sides of cirifalls, and then they get into the lake, and then they have paradise there. It's Eden. It's full with shrimps, snails, all kinds of food, and this is just paradise for them.
Finn Oakland is a research scientist from the Norwegian Institute of Nature Research and a specialist in tagging. He explains to us how that technology works.
Right now you see it's a magnet on it, and when we remove this magnet we activate the tag. And it's actually storing the information about light, the temperature and the depth. We put this on the eel so it will follow the movements of the eel and record those factors. But when it's in seawater, we cannot send any radio signals from seawater. So we have programmed the tags to release from the fish after 5 months. It gets up to surface and then it starts sending all the information up to Argos satellites, and then we get them.
All these works that are being carried out on Gaua in terms of awareness on conservation activities and researches are very important to maintain a balanced ecosystem, which is detrimental to the survival of the variety of species living on the island and to the livelihood of the people. Therefore, people have the responsibility to play their part in order to keep that balance. People need to change their behavior to ensure that their actions contribute to conservation and sustainable use of forest biodiversity. They need to have an ethical responsibility to be caring and be responsible managers or stewards of the resources. Our resources will continue to supply our needs in the future only if they are protected and sustainably managed today. We cannot live without them, so conserving them is a necessity. We must conserve and maintain the biodiversity of our land, as it is a fundamental part of our heritage. The hope of the next generation to enjoy this richness lies entirely in the hands of the present generation. Will they maintain it? That is the challenge.